So, we are reading letters that...
You wrote me when I was in basic training.
Yes. Actually, some of them are cards that we wrote when we were dating and when we were cute and young and full of life.
Dear Jeffrey, consider this the first of many letters you will get from me. Even though you are only leaving for 2 days, it still feels like we're going to be apart forever.
I love you so, so, so much. You are my dream come true. You are the best thing that ever happened to me. Jeff, I love you this much.
Dear Jeffy, you may not be the best storyteller in the world, but every story you told me meant the world to me.
Oh, Jeff, I just found $120.
I don't think that check's good anymore. That's 8 years old.
Happy 8 months.
Jesus, dude, I wrote a book.
I know, you used to write really nice things.
I am so sorry I burped while you're talking. Tastes like strawberry ice cream.
Today, I handed out the most precious and important part of my life to you, Jeff and Yaya. From today on, you two are in my heart forever and ever. I love you both with all my heart equally.
I heard a quote a long time ago. A great man has even a better woman behind him. And when he found Yaya, that was God-given. They're so loyal to each other, they love each other to death, and we can all see that.
Great.
Oh my God. I love you.
Jeff, I have written and rewritten this vow in my head a million times over the past decade. Each time I will be so overwhelmed with the amount of love I have for you, for us.
Yaya, I love you more than you can imagine. You are my person, my best friend. And if you feel yourself falling, I will be there as your parachute.
The memory stays in my mind. It's creeping like a ghost, never too far behind. Some things never let you go.
Throughout all our crazy years together, you have been my best friend, my rock, my shoulder to cry on, my person, and the love of my life.
You're the calm harbor to my stormy sea. Through the ups and downs, you're still the boy who comes running whenever I call crying.
Forevermore, your dreams are no longer your dreams. They're our dreams. You will not have to face this world by yourself.
In retrospect,
when you honor each other, you're saying to each other, you have a place in my home. You have a place at my table. You have a place in my life. You have a place in my heart.
When you asked me at 17 what my biggest ambition in life was, I told you it was to be a good wife and a good mom. And that on my deathbed, as I reflect back onto our life, I would be able to hold my husband's hand and thank him for an extraordinarily boring life. I vow to remember that you're everything I have ever prayed for.
Regardless of the circumstance, no matter Monday, you were there for me. I am forever grateful to you, and our love will only grow from here.
You make me feel like I can conquer the world with one hand, as long as you're holding the other.